In this section of the exercise, we'll be familiarizing ourselves with the AF structure of our ice cream plant. Go ahead and open up Pi System Explorer and navigate to the Pi World database by selecting the Database button in the top left corner and then choosing the Pi World database. Once you're there, go ahead and navigate on the left-hand side under the Elements to Exercise 1, then Process Area, then Line 1. Once there on the main section of the screen, go ahead and select on the Attributes tab and take a moment to familiarize yourself with the attributes here. Once you're done with that, let's navigate back on the left under Line 1 to Mixer 1 and take a look here at the attributes for Mixer 1. Specifically, I'd like to call out three attributes. First, let's take a look at the last maintenance date attribute. On the right-hand side, you'll see that this is a select statement looking up data from a table. To see the table, we'll navigate to the library, and then on the left-hand side under Tables, we'll find the table Maintenance System Data. Once there in the main section of the screen, we'll go ahead and click the Table tab, and you can see the table that populates that last maintenance date. Tables like this can be manually entered, but oftentimes come from external systems such as a maintenance database or other external data store. And those can be refreshed on a periodic basis based on how often that data changes. Okay, so back into the elements, let's take a look at the other attributes here. So you'll notice that there's a failure status attribute that simply outputs a Boolean failure or no failure. We will be using that later to determine if our asset is running, our mixer is running in this case. I also want you to note that there is an RPM value here. So each mixer has, if it's running, right, should have positive RPM. And there's also a valve attribute here. So when we're calculating if the mixer is running, we'll be looking for positive RPM as well as the valve being open. And we'll also want to make sure that there's no failure state going on. So we'll be using all that for in the next section to create a status attribute.